How many things do you really need to own?
Most of our homes are filled with stuff we only use once in a while.
Would it be possible to own less and share more? Many of us are already used to not owning that many books.
But instead going to the library to borrow books.
Sharing laundry machines isn't weird.
Is it also possible to not own our own bikes?
But instead share bikes with the rest of our city?
What if we learn to own less and share more already from a young age? Let me tell you about a place that does exactly that.
Welcome to the Toy Library.
It works almost like a normal library, but with toys instead.
At this library, they have a wide variety of toys that you can borrow. In order to borrow toys, you have to become a member and pay a yearly fee of your own choice between 300 to 500 Swedish kronor. Or you can get your membership by volunteering at the library.
And when you are a member, you can borrow two toys at the same time per kid. So if you have two kids, then you can borrow four toys. And it's for 28 days and you can extend the loan if it's not reserved by any other member. And you can also return it earlier and then come back and choose something new as often as you like.
But you can't only borrow toys here.
We also have baby articles like carriers and slings, babysitters and so on.
But the toy library has other purposes than lending toys.
Here at the toy library you can also just hang out and meet friends and try out toys if you want to. You don't have to be a member to stay here. And we also organize events like sing songs and crafting events and parental groups, like language groups, for example, that come here and play. And often the events are started by members themselves that organize them, and we more or less work as a facilitator, so they can just stay here.
Anna is one of the people behind this library, and she got this idea a couple of years ago.
It was actually when my first daughter was about a year that I started to feel like the small apartment started to clutter up with all the toys that wasn't really used very often. And I myself wanted to go to a toy library, but there were no toy libraries to find. And I did some research and saw that it was a lot of toy libraries in other countries, actually over 5,000 in Europe. So that was basically the starting point.
She started by buying the toys that would later be lent out.
Well, some of the toys are donated and some of them we have actually bought new. It's actually a question that we get quite a lot because most people think that when it comes to sharing, it has to be like secondhand all the time. But I think it's actually the opposite, that if it's one time that you actually need to buy new things, it's when it's supposed to be used for sharing. So we want to have things that are high quality and last long. And I also think it's about behavioral change and to get people to realize that sharing is as good as owning yourself. I think you have to show that it's really good things, that if you share them, you can actually get an extra value. It's not just that it's cheap or anything. You also get good things.
Sharing instead of owning has a lot of benefits.
The most obvious might be the environmental perspective of the whole thing, that we cannot continue to consume things that we do today, so we need to find other ways. And I think sharing is a good way of doing that. A lot of parents here are also happy because they don't have to keep and store all the toys at their home, which is actually a really good reason. A Swedish kid in average have 536 toys in the room, so it's a lot of things. Research shows also that having too much toys around you as a child, it can actually make it harder for you to focus on one play, and your play kind of gets scattered. So it's also good to not keep too many toys to help the kids' creativity.
But do we really need to involve our kids into this sharing economy thing?
I think it's important to teach the kids to share things, because the things that you do when you're young, you tend to take the behavioral with you when you grow older. So if you can learn to share things when you're young, you might take this with you when you grow older.